افراد را تسریع ببخشیم، جلو حملات نظامی بالای کابل را بگیریم.
The purpose of this trip was how to expedite negotiations on a political settlement of Afghanistan and stop a military offensive on Kabul.
متاسفانه خلاف انتظار مردم افغانستان و جامعه بین المللی، پروسه صلح سابوتاژ شد و از طریق رای حل نظامی تحریک طالبان وارد پایتخت افغانستان شدند.
Unfortunately, contrary to the expectation of the Afghan people and the international community, the peace process was sabotaged and a military objective was pursued.
از اینکه پروسه صلح در افغانستان، مذاکرات صلح در افغانستان به شکست مواجه شد و در افغانستان انکشافات نظامی صورت گرفت، ما متاسف هستیم.
Because the peace process failed and military activities took precedence, we are sorry for that.
اما از اینکه یک گروه انحصار طلبی که هم مردم افغانستان را گروگان گرفته بودند، هم پروسه صلح افغانستان را گروگان گرفته بودند، از صحنه کنار زده شدند، ما ای را با عنوان یک چانس و یک فرصت تلقی میکنیم.
But since a monopolistic clique who had taken hostages the nation of Afghanistan and the peace process had been removed, we consider this as an opportunity.
ما در امی اوضاع وارد اسلام آباد شدیم، ملاقات های سازنده و مهم میرن با آقای شاه محمود قریشی وزیر خارجه پاکستان، با جناب آقای باجوا رئیس ستاد مشترک پاکستان، با آقای حمید فیض رئیس ISI پاکستان و همچنان با آقای عمران خان صدر اعظم پاکستان ملاقات ها و مذاکرات مهم و سازنده داشته.
Under that circumstance, we entered Islamabad and held a range of constructive and very helpful meetings, namely with FM Qureshi and with Chief of Staff of the Army, Mr. Bajwa, DGISI Hamid Faiz, and finally Prime Minister Imran Khan.
هدف اصلی ما در این مذاکرات ای بود که ما در گام نخست چگونه بتوانیم جلو خشونت علیه مردم افغانستان را بگیریم، فضای به وجود بیاید که ما چانس تفاهم بعدی در آینده افغانستان را داشته باشیم.
The first and foremost objective was how to avoid and prevent bloodshed and violence so that to pave the way for a future reconciliation.
به این خاطر ما آینده افغانستان را به دو بخش تقسیم کردیم، از امروز تا تشکیل دولت جدید در افغانستان.
For that reason we split the objectives into two. First is from now until the formation of a new government.
در این مرحله توقع ما از دولت پاکستان ای بود تا از نفوذ خود بالای تحریک طالبا استفاده کنند، جلو خشونت، جلو خونریزی، جلو تشدد علیه زنان افغانستان، کودکان افغانستان و مردم افغانستان را بگیرند.
So what we engaged with the counterparts in Pakistan is to discuss how we could together prevent violence against the people, against the children, against the women in Afghanistan and stop
در این حال تقاضا کردیم که جلو داخل شدن تحریک طالبان را به ولایات و مناطقی که تا هنوز وارد نشدند بگیرند.
Furthermore, we discussed how to prevent an offensive on the areas and regions not yet taken by the Taliban.
ما از همه مسئولان و مقامات پاکستانی به نمایندگی از هیئت معیتی خود صمیمانه سپاسگزاری میکنم که همه با یک صمیمیت خاص عنوان کردند که ما آخرین تلاش خود را به خرج میتیم تا جلو خشونت را در افغانستان بگیریم.
On behalf of the delegation from Afghanistan, I thank all the authorities we met, because they have given us their promises that they will do everything under their control to stop this from happening.
خصوصا موقف و موضع‌گیری آقای باجوا و آقای فیض روشن در این موارد با آیت ما مطرح شد.
Especially position was very clear from Mr. Bajwa and also Mr. Faiz.
مرحله دوم شکلگیری حکومت جدید در افغانستان است.
The second phase is formation of a next government.
هیئت ما با صمیمیت و صراحت دیدگاه‌های خود را به نمایندگی از مردم افغانستان با همه مقامات پاکستان که ما توفیق مذاکره و ملاقات با ایشان را داشتیم مطرح ساختند.
Our delegation discussed everything very openly and frankly with all the authorities that we were fortunate enough to meet.
ما عنوان کردیم که خواست مردم افغانستان تشکیل دولت فراگیر بر مبنای مشارکت عادلانه اقوام و مذاهب و ساختار مورد قبول مردم افغانستان است.
What we argued is that the solution for the future settlement lies on a proportionate participation from all ethnic groups and all different faiths in Afghanistan.
ما مطرح ساختیم که ما با خواست مردم افغانستان متحد هستیم. هم دیروز موقف ما ای بود و هم امروز و فردا. ما در افغانستان آزادی، حقوق زن، حقوق اقلیت‌ها، انتخابات و اراده مردم افغانستان را و حاکمیت قانون اساسی را از جمله خواست‌های مشروع مردم افغانستان می‌دانیم.
We maintained in the past that we are committed to the desires and wishes of our people and we remain committed. And those wishes are freedom of expression, women's rights, rights of the ethnic groups, a right to choose a leader by the way of voting, and also the rule of law.
ما با یک حکومت تک حزبی و تک قومی در افغانستان هم دیروز مخالف بودیم، هم امروز مخالف هستیم.
We opposed a rule by one party and also by one side from the past.
ما موضع خود را روشن عنوان کردیم. اگر تحریک طالبان بخواهند دوباره اشتباهات گذشته سال 96 را تکرار کنند، از همکنون محکوم به شکست خواهند بود.
We've been very clear. We've been very clear if the Taliban are going to repeat the same mistakes as they did in 1996, they are bound to fail again.
اگر تحریک طالبان چنانچه ادعا میکنند که اونا تغییر یافتند، ذهن از اونا تغییر کرده، اگر واقعا تغییر کردن، این ادعای تغییر را در رفتار و در عمل به مردم افغانستان به اثبات برسانند.
But should they choose a different path that they argue they have changed, that has to be proven in practice and in behavior.
ما از حکومت همشمول در افغانستان تعریف خود را داریم. تحریک طالبان تعریف خاص خود را دارند.
From a comprehensive and inclusive government, we have our own definition, but Taliban have their own.
حکومت همشمول مالک بودن یک گروه، مهمان بودن بقیه مردم افغانستان در یک نظام، این نظام همشمول نخواهد بود.
An inclusive government cannot be defined as one party rules all and the other party is guest. That cannot be an inclusive government.
تعریف ما از حکومت فراگیر این است که همه اقوام افغانستان، همه مذاهب افغانستان، زن افغانستان، مرد افغانستان، نسل جوان 70% افغانستان با یک ساختار قابل قبول برای مردم افغانستان خود را صاحب سرزمین افغانستان بدانند.
Our definition is that every single living Afghan in Afghanistan and women and different ethnic groups see themselves represented in a structure that is just and fair.
و این نظام در سایه یک قانون اساسی بتواند در خدمت مردم قرار بگیرد.
And that led and governed by a constitution that could truly serve the people.
در این مورد هم مقاماتی را که ما صحبت کردیم دیدگاه روشن خود با ما مطرح ساختند.
And all the authorities we met, they have their own very clear ideas.
همه با یک صدا مطرح ساختند که ما از حکومت تقومی در افغانستان که تجربه گذشته است و تجربه ناکام گذشته است حمایت نخواهیم کرد.
They all were in unison that a monopolistic system governed by one party that failed in the past will not be repeated and they will not support it.
همه عنوان کردند که ما از یک نظام فراگیر و مورد قبول مردم افغانستان حمایت خواهیم داشت.
All of them said that they will support an inclusive and an acceptable government to all Afghanistan.
همه تأکید داشتند بر این که ما خواهان مناسبات جدید با افغانستان هستیم.
They further emphasized that they want to open a new chapter in terms of relations with Afghanistan.
برای ما دلچسب بود که هم در صحبت با مقامات نظامی و هم با آقای صدر اعظم و آقای قریشی ما از پاکستان جدید پیام گرفتیم.
It was fascinating that in all our meetings with the military and also with the civilian, we received the new Pakistan chapter from all.
پاکستان جدید، نسل نو، زمامداران جدید در هر دو بخش ملکی و نظامی با عبور از گذشته و با دید معطوف نسبت به آینده پیام مثبتی بود که ما از مقامات پاکستانی با خود گرفتیم.
This new Pakistan was a very positive message which leaves the past in the past and looks into the future.
دوستان عزیز، نمیخوایم وقت زیاد شما را بگیرم. از این لحاظ ما در ضمن سپاسگزاری از مقامات پاکستانی و تعهدات و صحبت‌هایی را که با ما داشتن جداً به نمایندگی از هیئت سپاسگزاری می‌کنم. نسبت به آینده خوشبین هستیم، امیدوار هستیم که این حوادث در کشوری که بارها تکرار شده فرصت‌های جدیدی را در اختیار مردم و نسل‌های آینده ما قرار بدن.
And thank all the authorities that are focusing on the future, and with that opening new opportunities for peace and stability in Afghanistan.
اگر سوالاتی مطرح بود مطرح می سازیم و سوالات با همه دوستای خود شریک خود ساختیم.
If there are any questions, our colleagues, members of the delegation, will be happy to
respond. سپاسگزاری میکنم. گرفتن جغرافیا غیر از گرفتن و تسخیر مردم افغانستان است.
Thank you. Capturing the territory is different from capturing the people.
ما نمایندگان مردم افغانستان هستیم.
We represent the people of Afghanistan.
من یقین دارم که تحریک طالبان هم این واقعیت را به خوبی درک میکنند.
I'm confident that the Taliban movement also understands.
افغانستان امروز افغانستان 96 نیست.
Today's Afghanistan is not the 1996 Afghanistan.
یک نسل جدید با بینش جدید و با دانش نو در افغانستان شکل گرفته.
A new generation with different with modern mindset and modern knowledge has taken place in Afghanistan.
امور رقمی که در 96 یک حکومت تک گروهی ناکام بود، ما یقین دارم که امروز ناکامتر خواهد بود.
Just like 96 that one party or one group government failed, if that was going to be repeated, that will fail too.
ما هم امروز در کابل شاهدی بودیم که صدای ملت افغانستان بلند است. تشکر.
Today we were witnesses of the people being very vocal on the streets of Kabul.
Sir, how do you see Ashraf Ghani escape from Afghanistan, and are you in touch with Taliban right now?
سوال شما
چون
بینیم که آقای سوال شما چون کدامتان پاسخ میگه؟ بدرام سیب.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحیم.
فقط سر سوال باشه.
مشخص بود که آقای اشرف غنی فرار میکند، این برای ما قابل فهم بود. همون جناب آقای خانون فرمودن خب یک تیم محدودی بودن که از حمایت مردم افغانستان برخوردار نبودن و در واقع غصب کرده بودن قدرت و ارتباش و هیچ کسی از اونا حمایت نمی کرد. طبیعی بود، اون قابل فهم بود، برای ما روشن بود. برای همین هم میخواستیم بگیم که در افغانستان باید قدرت به طور مسالمت‌آمیز به یک حکومت همشمول منتقل بشود و قانونی منتقل بشود و رسمی منتقل بشود. اگر ما نمیدانستیم که ایشان فرار میکنند که میمانند و مورد حمایتن، که اصلا بحث تحویل قدرت و ساختار و مسالی در کار در قطب ایشان ادامه میدادن کارشان مطابق قانون اساسی. بله، ما در جریان بودیم.
It was quite clear from the onset that you and the new structure had been known that he is not going to run away and talks about formulation of a new government, an inclusive government, and all.
There were allegations on the
form. I don't want to be sure that the
government, like the Zion Kuria, the Sante Ruskaya, was popular. Because what is the one?
آقای محقق پاسخ میگن.
البته غارت و چپاول اموال عمومی بودجه ملت چیه؟ از درآمدهای داخلی ما یا چی از کمک‌های بین‌المللی بر افغانستان میشد؟ او یک چیز نوی نبود که به آقای غنی نسبت داده شد که اونا روز فرارشان رو بردن. پیشتر از او مدت یک سال به این طرف عبارت سیستماتیک از طریق میدان هوایی با طیاره‌های بدون علامت اینا انتقال میشد.
ترجمه شد.
This diluting of national wealth and the treasures of the public is not something new. This had happened in the past through stealth airports, airplanes landing in Kabul airports.
البته گپی اخیر که گفته شد امیر از بعضی سفارت ها گفتن و باز هم تایید شد از طرف بعضی کشورهای کلان که 169 میلیون دلار بوده، این گپ گفته شد و خود آقای غنی گفت من یک چپلک خود فرگرد و فرار کردم، بیشتر از اون حتی فرصت نیافتم که کفش خود پای کنم، چطور میتونم که من پول بخود بیارم. خوی گپا گپای زد و نقیز است، اما در واقع همین حکومتی که آقای غنی داشت در حقیقت حکومت وظیفه نداشت جز انتقال پیدا کردن پول از راه های مختلف و بیرون بردن، این وظیفه شمی بود.
The accusations are that it amounted to $169 billion, but that aside, because there are some contradicting claims, he himself claimed that he had nothing but his sandals in his feet when he escaped from Afghanistan. But the thing is that this government had nothing to do but focus on the transfer of wealth.
موضوعی که دیگر که من یادآوری کنم، حکومت تنها فسادش در مسئله مالی نبود، بزرگترین فسادش و فساد تبعیض بود که همه اقوام افغانستان را از حکومت راند و یک حلقه خاص را با خود داشت که یک میراث بدی گذاشت، یک فاصله اجتماعی را زیاد کرد. عالی حکومت خو رفت، بحث رزیسته که حکومتی آقای طالبا که میه نکنه که از یک استبداد چپاول خلاص شیم با یک استبداد دیگه گرفتار شیم. و مخاطر است که ما آیتی که اینجا آمدیم هم با مقامات پاکستانی ایرای زنی را کردیم، هم شاید در سطح منطقه و سیر امی حیات باشه که یک حکومت فراگیر ملی شامل همه اقوام مذاهب افغانستان جور شود. طالبان نباید اشتباه آقای غنی را یا اشتباه دوره قبلی طالبان را تکرار کنند.
Financial corruption wasn't the only thing. The most important thing they did was engage in discriminatory activities within the system where they alienated, marginalized all ethnic groups from the government And that led to this collapse. And that, you know, is in the past now. What we are here for is to talk to the Pakistani authorities so that we stop having a repeat of same mistakes, same government under the Taliban movement.
Any question? Please.
How do you see the role of the regional power or formation of the central government to leave Afghanistan, financial issues and other problems? Russia, China and
NAFTA.
Thank you very much, and well, just to emphasize on what Mr. Qanwi, Mr. Mahaqiq, and Mr. Pedram says, and of course we are thankful for the leadership of Pakistan that we met the political leadership as well as military leadership. There were constructive talks about different issues, especially about peace and stability in Afghanistan, because we have always believed that Pakistan and Afghanistan, they are two neighboring countries, and everything affects each other. And therefore, any sort of instability in Afghanistan will, of course, affect the instability in Pakistan as well. Now, this is a new chapter, so the challenge is high, but we really have to take the opportunity out of these challenges. What opportunity do we have? Right now, at this moment, we have got an opportunity. Thanks God that the government of Pakistan, we extended an invitation months ago. It was from 17th to 19th of July that the first invitation extended, but unfortunately, we could not make it until it was the 15th to 18th of this month. Now we are here. We are opening a new chapter. We hope that we can really kind of strengthen our relation. Right now, at this moment, what Mr. Panuri emphasized, our priority is on how to curb violence inside Afghanistan by the Taliban, not only in Kabul, in different cities. That's our priority. And also our priority is on how exactly to refrain, to stop the attacks of Taliban, to those areas which have not they have not yet gone, especially the Panjshir Valley, as you know that they have not gone, in some other areas, in central zone of Afghanistan. That's very, very important. As you all know that my nephew, Ahmed Massoud, is there. And therefore, we are kind of trying to really safeguard these areas. And also, I know that there are some spoilers there as well. And if we were, every city, there are spoilers as well. But what we are really trying to do just to build on how exactly we can have the peace and we can solve the whole problem peacefully. You talked about this regional power. Of course, Pakistan is a very major player because we have got a long border here. And different regional powers are very important for Afghanistan. We have got six neighbors, and all these powers are very important. We have always said for achieving peace in Afghanistan, the first priority is that how do we exactly get the consensus from different ethnicity in Afghanistan? That's the must, that's the base for Afghanistan. If we have any sort of government which could represent the ethnicities of Afghanistan, that must be based on the ethnicity sharing of the power. Without that one, we will never see peace in Afghanistan. You could remember that, you know that Dr. Ghani, for the past 20 years, he really all the time, he tried to have all the power for himself. That's why, despite all the efforts of international community, he failed. He failed, and he failed Afghanistan. So we hope that the Taliban should not try the same thing. So that the power sharing amongst different ethnicity based on a decentralized system of the government in Afghanistan is a must. Power sharing based on ethnicity and based on the decentralized system of the government in Afghanistan is a must. So therefore, we are kind of concentrating on that one. That's the first priority. The second priority is the consensus of different countries, especially the neighboring countries. That's very, very important. And we have to really get every neighboring country to reach some sort of consensus there. As we discussed it here with the leadership, they're all ready for the consensus in Afghanistan and for the consensus in the region, in Israel region. And that's a valuable thing that we have got here. The last thing I really would like to say is that the meeting, the delegation of the Afghan leaders who have come here, this is not all. The next sitting will be a larger delegation. So some leaders who could not make it, like Ustad Atta Muhammad Noor, his young son is here, and of course, Haji Ismail Khan, Amisar Ismail Khan is a big leader. in the West. Of course, Marshal Dostum is another leader, Mansour Nadri is another leader, Ustaz Sayaf is another leader. So hopefully very soon we'll have a very big setting, big meeting of all the leaders. They're all trying for peace in Afghanistan. And hopefully that as we started from Pakistan, which is very prominent and playing very vital role for peace in Afghanistan, we can extend our trips and travel to different cities, to different countries, in order to really attract their backing and their support for the peace in Afghanistan. And that's very, very important. So, of course, first, inside Afghanistan, the consensus of the ethnicity is important. The second, the consensus of the regional power and extra-regional power is a must for Afghanistan.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Just یک سوال دیگر را میگیریم برای جوانترین ما و اکتفا میکنیم.
The last question. Also, I'll ask Mr. Noor to take that question.
میشه که از این خانم بگیریم که جندر رعایت شود. بفرمایید.
فرزانه حکیمی هستم. از بابا خانی میکنم. از تمام های شما خوشامدید میکنم. سوال منی است که شما خودشون بفرمایید از وقتی که طالبان آمده یعنی زنا خیلی زیاد در ترس و لرز هستن. خب اونا
خالد جان شما جواب میدید.
ما حق اونا میدیم. یعنی اونا میتونه درس بده خانه یا وظیفه خدا انجام بده. اما بعضا اونا که ما در پروتست شما رو در ویدیو دیدیم اونا بازم خواست اونا همی بود که ما حق خدا بخواییم یعنی و شما این زده پولیتیکل پارتی شما به چطور این شما کدا میتانید این حق زنان در افغانستان داده میشه آیا طالبان که فیلن که میگن که ما حق اونا رو میتانیم اونا میتانید دست بخانه وزیفه خدا جا آیا این دفعه بخاطر این که فیلن اونا حکومت سی گرفتن نتانسته این در بمونه یا وقتی که طالبان حکومت دستشان سی آمدن برزور حق اینا داده میشه یعنی
Thank you. خالد جان پاسخ می‌دهم. خالد نور.
Thank you very much. I'll try to answer it in English so everyone knows. Well, one of the main demands of our people is women rights, and that's something that we have been fighting for, alongside other freedom of expression, the election, the right to choose their leaders. And so this will be something that during our negotiations and our work for peace, women rights will be on top of our agenda. But at the same time, about the Taliban, first of all, I have to tell you that Taliban cannot rule by force in Afghanistan. They may have taken power by force. They may be in Afghanistan for some time, but it will be a very short time. If they do not respect the right of our people, if they do not respect the right of women, children, ethnicities, and the cultures of Afghanistan, then they are bound to defeat and to be removed from the country. So whatever they are saying now, it's more of a word. We haven't seen it in action. So we'll have to wait to see if they have really changed. I doubt it. I still do not believe they have changed. What they are doing is more of a publicity than a policy.
تشکر میکنم از حوصله مندی همه شما از سوالات خوبی را که مطرح ساختین و عذرخواهی میکنم که اگر دوستای چانس سوال کردن را نیافتن تشکر از همه شما
Thank you very much.